What's up internet, I am Manish from rebellionrider.com and I am back once again with another PLSQL tutorial. In this tutorial on native dynamic SQL, we will learn how to dynamically execute DDL statements using execute immediate. DDL stands for data definition language statements. Using them, you can create or modify the database objects as well as the schemas. These statements are create, drop and alter. You must be thinking, Manish, what could be the trouble in executing them? Right, no trouble as long as you are executing them with SQL. But when it comes to executing them with PLSQL, then it's kind of hard. So, is executing DDL statement with PLSQL that complicated? Let's do an example to find out the answer. In this demonstration, I will try to create a table by executing CREATE TABLE DDL inside a PLSQL block and we will see whether the table is created or there is an error. Here is our PLSQL block. What do you guys see? Will it create the table or not? Let's execute and see the output. Oops, an error. Do you know why we got this error? We got it because PLSQL does not directly support DDL statements. To execute DDL statement using PLSQL, we either need to take help of TBMS underscore SQL package or the advanced and improved way, which is the native dynamic SQL. So now in this tutorial, we will learn how to execute DDL statement inside a PLSQL block using execute immediate statement of native dynamic SQL. In case you are curious, I have already done tutorials on all types of DDL statements in SQL series. If you want to check, I will leave the link in the description. That being said, let's move ahead and learn how to write a create table DDL inside a PLSQL block using execute immediate statement in Oracle database. How about starting with a new and fresh worksheet? A quick tip. Shortcut for opening a new worksheet in SQL Developer is Alt plus F10. Let's connect with HR schema. Here we go. And let's close this one. We don't need it anymore. Great. To simplify this concept and make it easy to understand, let's first write the create table DDL, which we will be executing inside our PLSQL block using execute immediate statement. Here we have a very simple create table DDL statement using which we are creating a table with the name tut underscore 82 which has two columns, tut underscore num of number data type and tut underscore name of varchar 2 data type. Usually we end our DDL statement with a semicolon like this, but here we are not doing that. So let's delete it for now. You will learn the reason why and when should we actually use a semicolon further along in this tutorial, so keep watching. So here we have our create table DDL statement ready for our demonstration. Now let's open another worksheet where we will write our PLSQL block. Here we are. Here we have written the declaration section of our PLSQL block. In this section, we have declared only one thing, which is a variable with name DDL underscore QRY of varchar 2 data type with data width 150. We will be using this variable for holding our create table DDL query, which we just prepared. I have set the data width of this variable to 150, which I think will be enough for holding our create table statement. In case you think your statement is bigger than 150 characters, then you should set the data width accordingly. Now, let's move ahead and write our execution section. In this section, we will store our create table DDL statement, which we just wrote into this variable TDL underscore QRY using assignment operator. Then, we will try to execute that DDL with execute statement. Let's do that. Here, we started our execution section. Now, we will store our create table DDL into the variable DDL underscore QRY. For that, we will first write the name of the variable into which we want to store our query, which is DDL underscore QRY in our case, followed by the assignment operator, which in PL SQL is a combination of colon and equal to sign. Next, we will copy the create table DDL statement from the previous worksheet and paste it here. There are a few small yet important things which we have to do here. First, always remember that execute immediate treats DDL or DML or any other supported statements which you want to execute dynamically as a string of varchar 2 data type. And in PL SQL, we enclose any character or varchar 2 string into a pair of single quotes. Because of this reason, we have to enclose our create table statement into a pair of single quotes. Now, let's come back to the question of when should we put the semicolon. In case you are writing a DDL, DML or any SQL statement for execute immediate, then you must put the semicolon right after the single quotes into which you enclosed your SQL statement. For example, here if I have to put the semicolon, then I will put it right after the single quotes here. But if you want to write a PL SQL block and execute it dynamically using execute immediate, then you should put the semicolon right before closing single quotes, like this. We will learn about this in detail when we will do the dynamic PL SQL tutorial. In our case, we are executing a DDL statement. Thus, we will put the semicolon outside the single quotes only. So let's get rid of this one. And now it's a perfect DDL for our execute immediate statement. You can also read about ending a statement with semicolon in detail in the introduction of native dynamic SQL. Find the link in the description. Now that you have understood the proper way of writing a query for dynamic execution in Oracle database, let's move ahead and write the execute immediate statement and complete this PL SQL block. To execute your DDL statement dynamically using the native dynamic SQL, you simply have to write the reserved phrase execute immediate followed by the name of the variable into which you have stored your DDL statement. In our case, that variable is DDL underscore QRY. That's it. Here we have our execute immediate statement using which we are executing our create table DDL. After this statement, we have the keyword and, which indicates the end of execution section of the PL SQL block. And then we have a forward slash, which tells the compiler that the PL SQL block is complete. Now let's execute this program and see whether this time we will have our table created or get the error again. Before execution, make sure you don't have a table with the same name created in the schema. Otherwise, you will definitely get an error. In my case, I don't have any table created with the name tut underscore 82 in my schema. Hopefully, we should not have any errors on execution. Let's check. PL SQL procedure successfully completed, which means the table is created. Let's confirm it by checking the structure of the table tut underscore 82 using describe command. If it is created successfully, then we must have its structure. To do that, we first need to close this output panel. Here we go. Now let's write the describe command and check the structure. Execute. Here is our table with both its columns. So that is how we execute a DDL statement and create a table using execute immediate statement of native dynamic SQL in Oracle database. So next time if somebody tries to act smart and ask you if one can create a table using PL SQL, then go ahead and say yes with confidence, because now you know how to do that. Okay, That is one way of creating a DDL statement for execute immediate. The other way, which is more convenient, especially when your SQL statement is complex, is by dividing your SQL statement into multiple parts and joining it using concatenate operator. I will be explaining this way of building a DDL statement for execute immediate in the corresponding blog. You can find the link in the description. Hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new. If so, then please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Also, please follow me on my Facebook and Twitter. You know where to find all the links. This is the tutorial on how to dynamically execute DDL SQL statement using Execute Immediate in Oracle database. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.